If you don't have Google Analytics on your website right now, I want to encourage you to watch this video, get it installed on your website, because even if you might not think you want access to the data of how many people and how people are getting your website, how many people are getting your website and all that, you might 6 months from now or 12 months from now, you need to get that on your website immediately. And that's what we're going to talk about in this video, not just getting it on your website, but the best way, or the most practical or reasonable or the smartest way to get it on your website. Hi, my name is Adam from WPCrafter.com, where I make WordPress tutorial videos for non-techies. If you're new here, consider clicking on that subscribe button, hit the notification bell to not miss a thing. Let's jump right on into it. Okay, so there is a little bit of debate over the best way of implementing Google Analytics on your website. There's several ways of doing it. There's more than one way of doing it. And so what is the best way of doing it? And that's one of the things we're also going to cover in this video. So traditionally, what you would do is you would add it to maybe your WordPress theme. So your WordPress theme might have in its settings panel a spot where you can paste that in there, and then it's on your website, you're good. But see, here's the problem. That probably isn't the best place to have it, because what happens when you want to change WordPress themes? All of a sudden, that Google Analytics code goes away with your old WordPress theme. And that's why I strongly believe that it's the ideal way of implementing Google Analytics or any kind of tracking code on your website is via a plugin, not via your WordPress theme, or if your theme has a hooks module. Regardless, I'm going to show you both ways in this video. Okay, I'm not going to bore you with creating a Google Analytics account. Just go to Google, type Google Analytics, create an account. You probably already have a Google account for your Gmail or any of the Google apps, and you can use that same account for Google Analytics. But what you need to do is once you log into Google Analytics, you want to get into the admin area. So for me, it's on the bottom left right here. So I'll go ahead and click on that, and then it's going to pull up my options here. And so what I want to do is click right here where it says create account. Now, this isn't creating a Google Analytics account. This is creating a new account from within your Google Analytics for an additional website. And you can keep making these for new websites that you add. So we just need to fill this little bit of information out. So we're going to give it a name, and this is how we're going to refer to it in Google Analytics. A website name. This is because you might have an account with multiple websites if they're kind of interlinked. So you're going to probably just use the same name right here as well. And then we need to put the URL to the website, choose an industry, choose a time zone, and then we can check or uncheck these boxes. It's just info that you are going to allow to be passed off to Google. And that's pretty much all that we need to do it. So I'm going to do this right now. All right, so I've gone ahead and filled this out. So I'm going to create a new account for demo websites that I create here on the channel. So I named it WP Crafter Demo Websites. And for this particular website, I put the name Show the Demo. That's also the URL of the website. And so I popped that in there. I made sure to add this to HTTPS. You had an option, HTTP or HTTPS. I chose that. Chose a category, popped my time zone in. I unchecked all four boxes because doesn't Google have enough data already? They could probably access it regardless. So I'm going to go ahead and click on Get Tracking ID right here. We just need to check this box to agree, and then we need to click on Accept. It's just going to take a moment, and here we are. Here is the tracking code. It's right here where it says Website Tracking. So if you were just going to add this to your WordPress theme, this snippet of code, you could just go ahead, click in here, and then copy it. So I just clicked in there, I've copied it, I have it in my clipboard. So here I am in the back end of the WordPress website that I want to add this to. Now on this website, I'm using the Astra theme. And like I said, I don't recommend adding the code to your theme, but some people might want to do it. And every theme's a little different. I'm sure it'd be really easy to reach out to your theme developer or look at their documentation to find out where they suggest putting it. But I'll show you on the Astra theme, which happens to be the theme on this website and the theme that I use on mine. So I would go to Appearance and then first go to Astra Options. We're going to need to make sure the option for custom layouts is enabled. So I'm going to click on activate right here. It's going to go ahead and activate it. And then I can click on settings and it will just jump me right on into there. So here it says custom layouts. I'm going to click on add new. And for the title here, I'm just going to put Google Analytics code. Now, if you're not, and if you're familiar with Astro, you have Astro, but you're not familiar with the custom layouts module, it's got to be one of the main features of the theme. And you could do amazing things, very interesting things, like add these little snippets of code very easily. So anyways, I'll have a different tutorial on that. So I can paste the code in here, but that's not what you really want to do. You want to click right here. It says enable code editor, and I'm going to go there. And I'm going to just go ahead and paste that in, and there it is. So then I want to scroll down here where it says layout, and this is where I would choose hooks, just like that. And then for action, we would choose WP head, just like that. And it even confirms here, WP head, action to add custom styles, scripts, and meta to the bottom of the head tag. Technical stuff, just know you pop that sucker into WP head, and then you got to choose where you want this code to actually trigger, and we would choose right here your entire website, just like that. Go ahead, click on publish, and that's pretty much all there is with the Astro theme. We've just installed this script, and you can actually use this part of this video to add any, if you have live chat or any kind of tracking script, this is how you would do it in the Astro theme. I can click on custom layouts and I can see it's right there, and we are good. I don't like this, because if I ever stopped using Astra, which is a possibility in 3 or 5 years, maybe something better comes along and I want to switch to it, then I've got to mentally remember that I need to re-add this snippet of code to the new theme when I can just implement this with a plugin. So I'm going to go ahead and trash this, because that's not really what I wanted. So here's the plugin that I'm using, and I've looked at all of the various Google Analytics plugins for WordPress, and this is the one that I like the most, and it might surprise you. So I'm going to go to plugins, I'm going to click on add new, and we're going to just do a quick search here for Google Analytics, and I'll show you some of them and I'll tell you why I chose the particular one. Okay, so here are the most popular options, and I'll talk about them real quick. Google Analytics dashboard, that's okay, it's a little on the basic side. Monster Analytics, yes, you can add the analytics to your website very easy, but there isn't much value beyond that. This has kind of an upsell model. If we scroll down here, this is the one that I like. It's Analytify, and it's really good, and I'm going to show you why in a moment. So, but with all these, it's all pretty simple to get your Google Analytics on your website. This just happens to be the one that I like, and I'll just give you a quick advance notice. It has beautiful dashboards. So the problem with Google Analytics is when you want to check your analytics and you go to Google Analytics, it's like, man, I don't even know where to begin. It's just so complicated and confusing. And Analytify adds those analytics to your website in beautiful, gorgeous dashboards. So let's just go ahead and install this and get this connected on in. Obviously, there's not going to be any data there because I just added the website to my Google Analytics code, but I'm sure over time there will be more and more data that gets added. All right, so now I'm going to just go ahead and click on activate, and we will get this thing connected on in. So it's going to add a new option right here at the top called Analytify. So I'm going to click on dashboard right here, and this is where we start. So don't just click allow and continue. If you read this, it's saying, do you want to allow Analytify to be in touch with you? And essentially, it will send your email address to them. So if you don't want that, it'll go to them to their MailChimp email list, and then you would have to confirm it. So even if you accidentally did it, that's okay. Just click on skip this step if you don't want the plugin author to have your email address. All right, and then we would click right here where it says connect Analytify with Google Analytics. Now, when you click on it, it's going to take you to this screen where it says choose an account. Now, I only have this one account, so I'm going to go ahead and click on it. And right here, I'm going to click allow, and this is going to basically me giving Google Analytics permission to kind of share some information with Analytify. Not the company, but just the plugin on my website. So you don't have to worry about that. And so, all right, so now it takes me to here where it's all connected. What I need to do now is right here, I want to check this box that says install Google Analytics tracking code. So I want to use it for that. And then right here, I need to choose my profile for these two locations. So right here, I'm going to go in the drop down, and this is everything that I have, those different companies and websites I have on my Google Analytics account. So right here's the one I had just created where it was show the demo. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and I'm going to do the same thing here for profile in dashboard, just like that. Now all you need to do is click on save changes, and you have literally just added Google Analytics to your website. And what's nice is when you click on dashboard right here, it generates really nice looking dashboards. Now, initially, it's just going to take a sec to get the data from Google Analytics, and there's actually not going to be anything in there. But I mean, this is really, really beautiful dashboards that it pulls everything in here. Obviously, you're not able to see all the dashboards because there's no activity, but it's going to start populating. I really like this plugin. As a matter of fact, I reached out to the developer because I thought there were some changes that he could make to the plugin. So number one, right here, I see how it says in red, pro versus free. I suggested that maybe he could tone that down a little bit. So I'd hope to see an update come out soon where this might just be the same colors as these. It's great to have that info there, but the red just kind of is a little glaring and stands out. So here's one of my favorite features about this plugin is that when you're in a page or a post, it'll pull in the Google Analytics for that page or post. So right now, you'd have to log into Google Analytics and then you'd have to sort it, and it's just not that simple to do. And it's a little overwhelming at first, but when you have Analytify on your website and you click on post like this or page, and then you actually click into a post or a page, check this out. When you scroll down, and you can hide this if you don't like it, by the way, I like it. If you didn't want it, just go to screen options right here and where it says Analytify stats of this page or post, uncheck it, it goes away, you don't have to see it. I like this a lot. So when I'm looking at a post that I've written or a page that I might be doing something on, I can glance at it and see how much traffic's on that, in what time period, are they on mobile devices, are they on desktop computers, where are they in the world. I get all that data. Analytify just pops it right on in there. So like I said, we don't have any data right now, and that's why we look here and we actually don't see anything. Another nice thing, when you're actually looking at the dashboard, I like this a lot. It'll tell you if there's someone on your website right now. I kind of like that as well. Oh, there we go. So this is kind of where the dashboards are. As you can see, there's no information here because there's no activity. But I really like Analytify. They do have a add-on model that is much more affordable than the other top Google Analytics plugin, which is Monster Insights. I think that starts at like $200. This one's, I think it's like $40 or $50 or something like that. So when you click on pro versus free, you can see just some of the differences between the two versions. Oh, and they give you a nice little coupon there. It's a very affordable plugin. I think if you tried it and analytics, you wanted additional analytics out of the plugin, it might be something good to look at. So you can just Google them or go to their website, or I'll have a link down below. Anyways, this is what I'm using to add Google Analytics to my website. Super important to add it to your website. You might not care about the data today, but 12 months from now, you're going to be kicking yourself when you realize, man, I wish I had that data. So spend 15 minutes of your time, add it to your website. You're going to have analytics at your fingertips. You won't even have to log into Google Analytics anymore. It's just going to be right here at your fingertips. Hey, if you found any value in this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you have any questions, leave it in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching. I'll see you in the next video.